So here is the machinery for the synthesis of fatty acid. As we see just now, this is the fatty acid synthesis complex. It consists of an ACP acyl carrier protein and also six enzymes which are held together in this fatty acid synthesis complex. First of all, an acetyl coenzyme A is to that complex and is bonded to the KS subunit, and a malonyl coenzyme A comes to this complex and is bound to the ACP directly. First reaction, look here, this acetyl group is added to this malonyl group. What happens? Can you see this shaded area, carboxyl group shaded in green? That is going out in the form of carbon dioxide. That means the fatty acids in this complex is charged with acetyl and malonyl group. The first reaction has taken place. It is a condensation reaction, and this reaction has produced a new compound with a keto group on beta carbon atom, beta keto butyryl ACP. Alpha beta carbon is bearing a keto group, so this is beta keto butyryl ACP. This reaction is actually catalyzed by this KS. What is KS? Beta keto acyl ACP synthase. That is the first enzyme. And with that reaction, that acetyl group is transferred from KS to the ACP. Now the KS subunit is free, make a note of it. In the second reaction, there is a reduction. Look here, actually here there is a keto group. This keto group is reduced. Reducing hydrogen atoms are given by NADPH++. It is donating two hydrogen atoms. This double bond is broken. One of the hydrogen is added to this oxygen, it becomes an OH. The second hydrogen atom is added to this carbon, it becomes a CH group. Look here, CHOH. This hydrogen is from the NADPH++. This hydrogen also is from the NADPH++. What's the new compound? Here it was beta keto. Now it is beta hydroxy. Beta hydroxy butyryl ACP. So the beta keto group is reduced. This is the first of the reduction reaction. And which enzyme is responsible for this? Can you see this blue shaded one? That enzyme is responsible, beta keto acyl ACP reductase. Beta keto acyl ACP reductase is responsible for this reduction. Now, next reaction is a dehydration. Dehydration means what? Removal of water. One molecule of water is removed from here. How? Water is H2O. How is that water removed? It's very simple. There is an OH here. That OH is removed. And from the CH2, one hydrogen also is taken away. So one hydrogen from here, OH from here. So OH and H means H2O, water. Instead, a double bond is formed between this carbon and this carbon. Look here. This is the new product. This is a delta 2 butenoyl ACP, trans delta 2 butenoyl ATP. Why delta 2? Position of double bond is carbon number 2 and 3, between carbon number 2 and 3. Trans delta 2 butenoyl ACP. And which enzyme is actually catalyzing this one? It's very simple, dehydratase. Beta hydroxyacyl ACP dehydratase. Dehydratase, this enzyme which is shown in the blue color. And in the next reaction, reaction number 4, it is also a reduction. Already there was a reduction here. This is the second reduction. Here also, reducing equivalent hydrogen atoms are given by NADPH plus H plus. Two hydrogen atoms are donated. What's the purpose? This double bond should be converted into single bond. How is it possible? Two hydrogen atoms are given. One is added to this carbon, while the second is added to this carbon. So this will become a CH2. This also will become a CH2. And you can see here, this is the resulting product is a butyryl ACP. And which enzyme is responsible for that reaction? It is very simple. This one ER, what is ER? ER is enoyl ACP reductase. There are actually two reductases. First one is the beta ketoacyl ACP reductase, which catalyzes the first reduction. This is the enoyl ACP reductase, which is carrying out the second reduction reaction. So now a saturated small fatty acid is produced. And there is one more reaction. Where is this butyryl ACP now attached to the ACP? From the ACP, it should be transferred to the KS complex, to the KS subunit. So there is a translocation. And that translocation is catalyzed by AT. What is AT? Acetyl-CoA ACP transacetylase. Or we say fatty acyl ACP transacetylase. From this ACP, this fatty acyl group is transferred to the KS subunit, so that this SH is now free. First round is completed. What happens in the second round? Another molecule of malonyl CoA approaches and is combining with this ACP. Another molecule of malonyl CoA, actually the second molecule of malonyl CoA comes here. It is combining with this ACP here. Again, the reaction is repeating. Here now what is there? Now, Once the first round is over, here it is not acetyl subunit, but it is butyryl subunit. So now the butyryl subunit, the butyryl ACP, butyryl unit is added to this malonyl CoA and carbon dioxide is removed. And there is a beta keto subunit, such a group is there, and this reduction, dehydration, reduction, transfer, all these reactions are continuing as such. And after every round, the carbon number of the resulting fatty acid is increasing by 2. Why by 2? Because a malonyl group is added during every round and one carbon is lost as carbon dioxide. Remaining 2 carbons are attached onto that product, or we say to the intermediate. So the length of the carbons is increasing by 2. Length of the hydrocarbon chain is increasing by 2 during every round. And you just think about the reaction. Suppose a palmitic acid is being produced. How many carbons are there in palmitic acid? There are 16 carbons in palmitic acid. How many rounds of this reaction should take place? Remember, 2 carbon units are added during every cycle. And there are 16 carbon atoms in palmitic acid. So how many rounds of this reaction should take place so that a 16 carbon palmitic acid can be produced? Just think about it. Is it 7 or 8? Is the reaction taking place 7 times or 8 times? Think about it. And the same thing is written in the text also. Condensation reaction is their first one. Acetoacetyl ACP is produced. Ketoacyl ACP synthase is the enzyme. Then there is a second reaction, is the reduction of the carbonyl group, and by means of NADPH. Remember, it is not NADH, it is NADPH. Then there is a dehydration, removal of water. Then there is one more reduction, and finally there is a transfer. That is how the reactions are taking place. So that fatty acids, the long chain fatty acids are produced like this. This is a table which is showing the name of individual proteins in that fatty acid synthase complex. Fatty acid synthase complex and their functions. Acyl carrier protein is the carrier of acyl groups. It is in thioester linkage, mechanote of it, thioester linkage. Then there is the transacetylase and synthase, transferase, reductase, dehydratase, etc. are there, and their function also is given. And look here, first of all, this is the same series of reactions. And how many times it is repeating? How many times it is repeating to form a palmitic acid molecule? Think about it. And I have given you this textbook. What is this textbook? It is Leninger's textbook actually. You can refer to that textbook also for more notes. If you have any question, you can ask me commonly in the group. Okay? Yes. And I need to tell you one more thing. See, this is a picture of the cytoplasm. The cell. Here, inside the mitochondrion, some of the reactions related to fatty acid is taking place. Which reaction? Breakdown of the fatty acid. Breakdown of fatty acid is taking place inside the mitochondrion, while synthesis of fatty acid is taking place in the cytoplasm. Make a note of it. Breakdown of fatty acid is taking place in the mitochondrion, while synthesis of fatty acid is taking place in the cytoplasm. Okay? Yes.